Okay, guys, this is the Harbor Freight 224cc Predator engine. We'll get this thing opened up and take a look at it. We got some reject kits for the carburetor. Okay, that's good. And a lot of plastic. Okay. Get stuff out of the way. And a bad looking little old gal. Looks like about the same footprint as the 212. Let's see what we got here. Yeah, I like the color. And this looks real familiar. That's looks like the same oil shut off. And on off switch is the, oh, wait a minute. Hey, this is a, looks like a reinforced block here. What we got going on? Okay, we'll give it, oh yeah, it is reinforced. Now that is a really nice feature. Now we've gone up to, we got $100 in a block right here. Oh, side cover's got a different hole there. Okay, extra hole. But let's see, DH225. Yep, DH225 and a bunch of other numbers. I don't know, I'll script that sticker off there. There we go. Anything hit underneath? A couple more support ribs. That's good. Side cover looks the same, but boy, I really like this. I like this. And we've got an emission system here already. Little charcoal canister down there. I guess that's okay. I don't know how long that's going to last, but we'll leave it on there. Save the planet. And whoa, what's that? That carburetor says Ducar. Oh. Now, why would a Harbor Freight engine say Ducar on the carburetor? That's kind of strange. Yeah. Lines go up here. Okay. Yeah. Gas tank. Vent lines from the gas tank. Okay. Yep. Yeah. Now, this is what I've been wanting to see. Let's see what this air cleaner's got it under here. Do we have a decent filter, or we just have a little piece of foam seat padding? We got, oh, yes. We have got the oval cartridge type filter. Oh my goodness, this is, that's a Ducar. Look at that. It's got these diagonal air inlets with the oval air filter. That is a Ducar breather. It sure is. Okay, I'm liking this. Oh yeah, I like that. Like that. So far, I'm pretty happy. Max performance 224. Okay, well. And here's the old tried and true Predator. Now this is actually a newer engine. I've had it in the box over there, it's just dirty. Hey man, it don't say Ducar on its carburetor. It just says, what is that? Ruzing or something. And the mufflers. Yep. Looks like about the same footprint engine. Nope. Nothing Ducar on there, alrighty. Ruzing. Oh, yeah. OHV. Got that octagon shaped valve cover. We got the same thing over here. This is a non-Hemi engine. Okay. I would rather it been a Hemi, but that's okay. We can work with this. Side covers. Huh? Well, no, I guess the original has got that little bolt, extra bolt up there too. That's probably mounted on some sort of pump or something. I don't know. I've never used that hole. And this is not reinforced. Nope. That's the 212. Good blocks, but it's not not a reinforced block. And let's see. Same, yeah. It's got the low oil shut down. Same exact thing. And what's this block say? R210. Okay. Well, the other one said 225, right? Yep. DH225. Huh. Yep, same switch. Same oil, okay. Same, look like same sensor, everything. So that's not changed. They've kind of carried that over from the 212 Predators. Bolt holes, yeah. And yeah, mufflers look real similar. Maybe not exact, but really, really close. Of course, this is the older engine too. I didn't pick up a new 212 to compare them. I should have, I guess. This is one of the older. That's probably about 10 years old. This engine. And that's different. Okay, that's got, looks like a little plastic cover over their throttle, or maybe a plastic throttle lever. Now I've seen those. Oh, look at that. Got these little chrome acorn nuts. Kane Custom Garages like those. Oh, yeah. No fancy acorn nuts on the old 212. And let's see. Spark arrestor in there? Nope. One in the new one? Nope. No spark arresters. That's okay. Yep. Octagon shaped valve cover. Only difference is like they painted this one black. And here's the 224 Predator flywheel. It has got the screwed and glued cast iron flywheel on it. And that's a problem. Those tend to come apart on everybody. What about the coil? The coil looks to be about the same. Yeah. No changes there. I wonder if it's one of those rev limiting coils. Huh. We'll check it out anyway. Oh, yeah. This is just a little short me fishing here, guys. Had to drop the drain plug down in the oil can there while I was draining her out, but that's okay. The magnet could use a little extra oiling, and this is just a little tool maintenance here. Make sure you keep your tools oiled up good. And let's get this drain plug back in there so I don't be dropping it in another bucket of oil anywhere. Okay. And it's a 10 millimeter. Just be sensible when you tighten that down. Now this is going to be difficult. I got to get it to where you guys can see and I can see too. Yeah, Well, everybody knows how to break loose bolts, so get these broke loose. I'm going to speed this up a little bit. Yep, don't knock it off the table. All right. Keep a chop rag under there, catch up a mess. See what we got here. Just a little tap, tap, tap. Gently. Let's not tear up that gasket. Yeah. Doesn't take much. Yeah, my gasket got kind of stuck there, guys. I had to take a screwdriver to peel it off there a little bit. And, oh, plastic can. Well, nylon, actually, I guess it would be, but yeah, I don't like that. Don't like that, but that's okay. Nylon. Dang. Well, that's okay. That's a good looking crankshaft in there. Now that is a, looks like they've clearanced that. That's a stroker crank, it looks like. Two inches, 283 thousandths. Checking out this cam. I'm sorry I'm not showing it to you guys. I forgot the camera was zoomed in here, so I'm just sitting here admiring it off camera. $225. And you can't really make it out against the white there. But let me put a light on here. Oh, wait. No, no, no. This is a glow-in-the-dark camshaft. Yeah. That's fluorescent. And let's see. What are we going to measure out here? 549 thousandths on the camshaft main shaft, right? That is a clone camshaft. And the cam's been clearance too for the stroker crank. And let me get in, got a piece of grit or something there between it. Let me check. Okay, 549 thousandths. That is a clone camshaft. That is a clearanced clone camshaft. Well, it's not staying in there. I'll get an aftermarket clone cam and clearance it and stick it back in there. But I'm really liking that crank. The counterweights are pretty thin already. And you can see it's been machined on the sides of the counterweights. That looks really good. The bottom looks like it's been machined too a little bit. Huh. And what we got in here? Let's see, what is up? Oh, Ducar right there on the block. There is the story, ladies and gentlemen. This is a Ducar engine, but it's not a Hemi head. Yeah, that's odd. It's got a non-Hemi type head on there. So what we're looking at here, it's probably a 225 Ducar with that Wildcat stroker crank from the 223cc Wildcat engine. Now the diameter on that rascal, let's see, is, that would be 160 thousandths over stock stroke. The stroke is 2 inches, 283 thousandths total stroke. The crank diameter, 1 inch, 178 thousandths with a 58 millimeter stroke. Let's crank it up here. And I don't think it has a rev limiting coil on there. Well, she runs. That's all I got, guys. Thanks for hanging out with me.